Saturday morning, I'm going away with my friend. Will Saturday spend till the end of the day? Just I and my friend. We'll travel 4 miles in our Saturday smile. Then we'll move on, but we will remember long after Saturday's gone.
Our live call-in show. We have a great show for you tonight. I'm joined tonight by my lovely co-host, who's also an attorney. We'll talk about that later. That's Ms. Samantha Caldwell. Welcome back to the show.
I am glad to be here.
How you been doing?
I have been doing very well.
Well, we was off set. We were talking about her attorney-client privileges, and so you notice she has her name on the show. There's some things that's going on I have in the background that I need to get my attorney to talk to her attorney about, but we're going to work it out for the Stay and Watch show. Well, we got a great show. We got a great band tonight. Rhythmic Rain, is that right?
Yes.
How about that?
Right.
I remember that. And they're going to be playing throughout the show tonight. So call somebody, let them know we're on Channel 25, Comcast Channel 25 and Studio 25 here in Chamblee, Dunwoody. We'll be right back. You watch the Stay and Watch the show. Rhythmic Rain, and again, welcome to the Stan Watson Show. I'm your host, Stan Watson, along with my lovely co-host, Ms. Samantha Caldwell. We have a great show tonight, don't we?
We do.
We got to get right into this, because we got a lot of people that want to be on the show tonight. So remember, you can give us a call at 770-559-2999. We'll take any call that you have tonight. Our first guests are Nick Host and Cecilia Chavis. Did I say that right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, all right, and it's Workout Anytime.
Yes, sir.
What is Workout Anytime?
Well, it's a full-service 24-hour gym. And okay. Me and my wife and a couple business partners actually just opened it about 4 months ago.
4 months. Where are you located?
Actually, we're located in Stockbridge, but there are two other locations that are actually in DeKalb County.
Oh, really? We're in DeKalb County? You hear that, DeKalb County? Yeah. Okay, DeKalb can't hit it, though.
Okay. Well, I got to throw that out there. Right. I mean, I'm definitely a DeKalb County product, too, and I definitely know, you know, we want to reach out to as many people, you know, really, as possible.
So the two locations in the cab, where are they?
There's one off La Vista Road.
Okay.
Okay, and there's one off Chamblee Dunwoody.
Mm-hmm. Awesome. Okay, okay.
Yes, sir.
Great. Yeah, two great locations, yeah.
Yes, sir.
Now, a lot of times people say, well, you know, I'm getting into the business. The franchise industry for workout facilities like yours and others we won't name are coming more apparent around the country.
Yes, sir.
What made you get interested in this? I'm sure it was not just fitness. I'm sure it was some monetary gains as well. Tell us a little bit about that and how you got
into
business.
Well, I mean, I've been a GM of a big box gym for the past like six
big
or seven
box
years.
Gym. Okay.
Yes, and you know, in a big club, it's kind of hard to get personal. I mean, hard to get personal with all of the members. Mm-hmm. And with me having such a big passion for the fitness industry, being that this past year was a year that I decided to kind of take everything I learned and apply it to my own business, I wanted to try to figure out the easiest way to put myself in the best situation so that I can give the community as much as possible when it comes to anything they might need to accomplish their goals and be at in a position to do or be as personal as possible with them.
Yes.
That way, you know, whatever kind of questions you might have, I can answer them in the gym without being bombarded with 300 other, you know, members.
So sweaty. This is a full service gym?
Full service. It's 24 hours. It's every piece of equipment you could think of when it comes to working out. And of course, in my particular facility, we really specialize in personal training. I mean, because usually the way I look at it, I always say a gym is a gym. They all have treadmills, ellipticals, equipment, in most cases, people need that accountability in order to stay consistent.
Yours, it sounds like it's more hands-on. I know in some of the big box gym, they may have a personal trainer, but he may have 10 women over here working out and he's back and forth. So see, how do you figure into this? You know, seeing the big box theory, I hear your husband say that he wants to be hands-on. How do you figure into this?
Well, me personally, I'm an educator.
Okay.
So I love to educate people on the benefits of a healthy lifestyle. Mm-hmm. During the school year, of course, I'm in the classroom, and then once I leave the classroom, I go to the gym to assist my husband. Mm-hmm. And it's just great to see the results people mm-hmm. receive and how their lifestyles have changed. Mm-hmm. And, you know, we get stories all the time where clients come from the doctor and their doctors are just shocked at, you know, how much their health has improved just from coming into the gym 2 times a week.
Mm. So doing some kind of walking or something.
Okay? Yes.
So
I'm big on, you know, the betterment of life and, you know, being a partner with my husband in the gym has given me the opportunity to look at it from the physical side, and being an educator has taught me to focus on the mental side. So I get to tap into both.
That's balance.
That's a battle team right here. It's a great team. So now, how long have you guys been doing that? I'm sorry.
Well, of course, I've been in the fitness. I've been an athlete all my life, and you know, once I finished, you know, my career, it was just more so trying to figure out what I didn't mind doing for the rest of my life. And
were you a football player, baseball player?
I played football into college. After college, that was it. And of course, my favorite subject in school was like PE. I can spend. I'm a gym junkie, so I didn't mind being in gym all day. And once I found
out making money doing it now, too.
Yeah, that's good.
Once I found out I could help other people, then I said, "This is where I need to be." It was just all about learning what I need to learn. And I'm very patient, and I'm a sponge. So I took everything I could learn from the corporate world and got with a great team, and we made it happen.
So I was going to ask about classes. You mentioned doing the educational piece. Do you have classes that you teach? And are those, you know, teaching with books or teaching with action or both?
In reference to the gym, we offer group clinics where my husband and his other training staff, they really lead those. They do teach people just different variations of workouts. We would love to add that aspect to the business once we grow to that point, but right now we focus more on the physical aspect, teaching people, you know, correct form, things, that's exercises good. They can do not only in the gym, but at home
even
as well,
or at work,
everyday life, you know, just to get them accustomed to the healthy lifestyle and to feel comfortable as well.
Well, that's awesome. Now, you have plans for expanding? You say you have two here and one in Stockbridge, I heard?
Yes, sir. Well, there are actually a total of about 13 to 14 clubs here in Georgia.
Really?
Yes, sir. And this is our first location.
Okay.
And definitely with the success that we've had just in the first 4 months, we're already starting to game plan on where the next one's
going to
be.
You got it going on, though, Nicole. Yeah. Now, you know, the big box theory is now they're making it affordable. You know, making it forward to try to make sure you come back.
Exactly.
You know, some people's, I'm not calling the name again, but $10, $5 a month, you know, and we'll let you come in. What are you guys doing?
That's actually one of the main reasons we went with this particular model, because the advantage that we have over a big box is, number one, is 24 hours. So, you know, usually when people decide that they want to work out, you don't want the gym's times of operation the biggest thing I wanted to eliminate is that excuse of, well, I don't have time to work out.
Right.
And I tell people, all my members, I say, you got keys in my house. So,
you come when you want to.
Okay.
Right.
And then from there, it really still comes down to knowing what to do. And that's why we are big on sitting every member down and actually having an introductory session where I can break down all their goals. But the other thing was, yes, it's $15 a month.
Okay.
And so with it being 24 hours, $15 a
month. Personal training. Personally, you're there all the time. Somebody's there to do the...
Well, we have staff hours.
Yeah, staff are doing attention.
And then from there, it's a month-to-month membership, too. Mm-hmm. That way, you never feel like you're constricted to the workouts.
That's a good model. And I should also mention, we've also branched out into the schools. As I mentioned earlier, I'm a teacher.
So I heard you were at Canby Lane.
Yes, I used
to live on Snap Ring Away years ago.
Yes.
You know that, huh? Right around the corner. are the bumblebees, yellow jaguars,
yes.
hornets, something
yes,
like that.
Yes, the bees.
Bees, okay.
Yes, yes. Canby
like
Lane bees. And what we did was we started a fit camp for the teachers at the school.
Oh, excellent.
Because, you know, one of the biggest complaints, we're stressed out. We don't have the energy. So, you know, as a team, we decided, well, let's start a Canby Lane. We called it the Fit Camp. Mm-hmm. And what the teachers did is several days out of the week, they would come into the gym and we would work out and, you know, just encourage them
True.
And That's try great. To guide them and give them stress relief
okay.
after school. So we're trying to not only just focus on the gym, but mm-hmm. reach out to the community as
That's
well.
That's good. That's excellent.
See, sound like y'all got it going on.
It does.
So, lastly, before I let you go, what's your standard age? I mean, what's the average age of the people in your gym?
Well, you have to be 16 to have a membership.
Right.
Of course, if you're 16, in order to sign up for the gym, you have to be accompanied by your guardian.
Okay.
But being that it's a full functional gym, we're big on general fitness. I mean, we're training everything from professional athletes to people with no limbs, you know,
right.
just
yeah.
trying to, yeah. you know, promote a healthy lifestyle.
Right.
I tell people, age is nothing but a number. I mean, you control, you know, what your body
That's
feels
right.
like, what it looks like, and as long as you have guidance, and it does take accountability.
Right.
I mean, I know how to work out, but I don't work out by myself.
Right. Okay.
I mean, it's usually easy for athletes to understand you're in the best shape of your life when you got a coach, you
right.
know,
exactly.
holding you accountable.
He's making you accountable.
Exactly.
We're going to do this today. Yeah.
Exactly. Running laps,
yeah.
too.
Yeah. How many kids come to you? I know there are a lot of children now that are in sports, and sometime in off season they want to go work out, and parents are now buying memberships to
right.
to different boxes and clubs. Mm-hmm. Are you open for that as well?
Oh, yes. We work with a lot of student athletes.
Gotcha.
And even with my business partners, they have a lot of knowledge in the fitness industry mm-hmm. as well. And anytime you can have that kind of older mentor mm-hmm. to not just talk about, you know, working out,
right.
and but just about our experiences
sure.
growing up
right, right.
as student athletes mm-hmm. and letting them know that, look, it's going to end at some point, you know. I mean,
not it's not going to be running at 40
right, right,
years,
right.
every
sure
year.
Will.
Oh, no.
Sure
right.
will.
So,
well, Terry almost thinks so, but anyway.
And a lot of times, even when it comes to just, you know, parents having that other person outside of the house explaining
kind of
to them. Exactly. Because
yeah.
sometimes when you're with mom and dad, it's kind of like, okay, mom. Dad,
I'm not going to do this today. Okay.
But,
all
but
right.
when you're hearing the same thing from somebody else that you might look up to,
work
it
hard,
comes across a lot
hard.
Different
yeah.
To them.
And we work with, just to mention a name, Joshua Outlaw, mm-hmm. who went to Martin Luther King High School. Mm-hmm. He received a full scholarship to Texas Tech University. Mm-hmm. So, you know,
what did he play wide receiver at Martin Luther King? Or?
Offensive line.
Offensive line, okay.
Mm-hmm. Left tackle.
Yes, mm-hmm. yes.
Well, good, so, well, good. Well, give us your information before we let
yeah.
you go.
Okay.
Where you located, phone number, somebody want to check
okay.
you out?
Well, we're located,
right,
we're located right off Highway 138 Southeast in Stockbridge. You can contact me directly, 404-518-2550. That's Nikos Chavis. And if I don't pick up, don't hesitate. Leave a voicemail, shoot a text message. I will respond back to you.
Like give them one in the cab now. I can't just let you
Oh, yeah.
Come on now. You see that?
Well,
the address. Yeah.
Definitely. The one off La Vista is located right off Briarcliff.
Mm-hmm.
It's in the same shopping center as Napoleon's.
Okay.
It's
2849 La Vista Road.
Okay,
right.
gotcha.
And then the Dunwoody location is 4490 Chambly Dunwoody Road.
Gotcha.
Yes.
Excellent.
And the good thing is, once you're a member of one, you're a member of all of them. And that's a big deal because.
No excuse. So once you sign up for one, you sign up for the other.
That barcode gets you in every last one of our facilities.
Cool.
Yes, sir.
Well, Cecilia and Nicole's workout anytime has
she
been.
She likes to be called CJ. I just
oh, excuse me. CJ. CJ and
Nikos.
Can I say Nikos?
Oh, yeah,
okay.
Sorry.
Nikos.
Yes, sir.
Thank you for coming by to stay and watch the show.
Definitely.
We appreciate
thank you for having me.
And let us know what we can do to help you, okay?
Yes, sir.
All right,
thanks.
Thank y'all for coming. We'll take a quick break, and Samantha and I will be right back with our next guest. But as we go out, I want you to hear this great band, Rhythmic Rain. y'all bring a camera? Bring a camera?
Camera, yes.
Okay.
She mentioned me about a cancer walk y'all were gonna do.
Yeah, and get that from her, yeah. We'll take a quick.
But yes. Nah, nah.
You know how to do. Good to have you here.
Nice to be here. Nice to be here.
The Stan Watson Show. I'm your co-host, Samantha Cardwell, and I'm glad to introduce to everyone our actor, model, Mr. Tony Parker. Welcome, Mr. Parker.
Yay.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you
for
being here.
Glad to have you here. Glad to have you here tonight.
It's an honor.
It's an honor to be here.
Yeah.
Absolutely. I finally made it.
I know each other.
Yeah, he beat me up a couple of times in the barbershop. That's okay, though. You know, I've been in a couple of barbershops and they talk about me and ran me out, but that's okay.
But you know what? We got a lot of love for you, though, Commissioner.
We got a lot of love for you, Commissioner, at the barbershop. I love it. Samantha said you do all kinds of stuff, and we know that. Talk about what you do. I mean, just tell the people what you're doing. You're an actor, model, barber extraordinaire. You probably don't do that anymore, but tell them what you do.
Well, I'm trying. Actually, I still cut hair.
Oh, you do? Okay.
Absolutely. Right. Absolutely. Okay. In DeKalb County.
Okay.
All right. I love DeKalb County. Actually, Dynamic Cuts Barbershop.
Right. That's off of, don't you ever know, the Redan Road, right?
Redan Road. Redan and South Indian Key Drive.
Okay. I've been there before.
Okay.
Right. But anyway, I used to work for DeKalb County in Road and Drainage,
okay.
but I pursued a life in the electrical trade.
Right.
Okay. Did that for a few years, mm-hmm. and I decided to take it to the acting career.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I did an electrical job for Candy Burrs. Mm-hmm. And from there, I got inspired just by watching them film, mm-hmm. watching them on set. Man, okay. I was just so like elated just to be it. Oh man, I don't even do electrical work no more. I do it on the side sometimes. Don't get me wrong.
Okay, so you were really inspired, huh?
Yeah, okay. Right. I do it on the side sometimes, okay. You know. But however, the acting career had just it just been overwhelming.
Right.
A lot of people say, "Hey, man, you got favor." I'm like, "Well, hey, no, it's all the setbacks and the triumphs." You know, I've been dealing with.
It became
you know,
a favor.
Oh. Absolutely. Right. Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Awesome. Excellent. What are you, go ahead,
oh, I was going to say, what's your most latest project? I know you're doing a series now. Are you involved in a series now?
Well, actually, currently, right now, I'm in a stage play called Deceived.
Okay.
And that's with Alicia Dupree
okay.
as a producer.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And that's what I have going on. And right I also now. Have, right, also in September, that. Is the first annual Dream Achievers Award.
Dream Achievers Award, okay.
I'm the presenter. Okay. At first they said, well, you gonna be a host. I said, a host? I said, I don't know about that one, but
yeah,
I don't have experience. It's
a lot of work.
It is a lot
that's
of work,
a lot
being
work.
A host.
Yeah, yeah,
right.
Work.
But the presenter, I'm
keep
thankful.
The crowd moving.
I'm real humble. I'm right. thankful for it.
Awesome.
And I know it's many more things to come.
Sure.
So I just wanna, you know, remain humble. You
well,
know?
Where's the presentation gonna take place?
Actually, it's gonna be at the Georgia World Congress Center.
Okay, all right. Mm-hmm.
Georgia World Congress Center, September 27th. I will be the presenter.
The presenter. Now,
absolutely.
Who are some of the award personnel? Or what is it for? What are we doing this for?
Actually, this is, you know, everybody have dreams. So it's sort of like the people that's already pretty much made it, that set right. examples for everybody. Mm-hmm. You got Michelle. You got Barack Obama.
Mm-hmm.
You got Tyler Perry, mm-hmm. you know.
Yeah, Tony people. Parker, go ahead.
Oh, yeah, yeah, Tony Parker, Tony Parker.
Throw it in. Oh, Michelle, yeah, right.
But okay. No, it's actually, it's an honor to really be
okay.
a presenter and get a mm-hmm. chance to be on the same stage and
sure.
just you know, an opportunity. So I just thank God for opportunity.
Mm-hmm. Now, what's some of the TV shows or sitcoms you've been in?
Oh, wow. Well, The Game, BET.
Okay, and are they on tonight, new series tonight?
Yes, the new series tonight.
10 o'clock
I'm not on that series.
Okay.
I wish I was, though.
Sorry.
He has been on
The Game. Okay, all right, okay.
Well, yeah,
the new series starts now.
Right. I'm actually the trainer in The Game, season
okay.
six.
Mm-hmm.
I'm the trainer in The Game.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Absolutely.
Now, do you actually train, or were you acting there?
Uh-huh. Well, actually, uh-huh. since I have a passion
okay.
for fitness, I actually was training as
okay.
well as... Yeah, a little acting.
Little acting on the side.
It comes natural.
Right, it comes natural.
Okay.
Now, a lot of those actors from The Game reside here in Atlanta, is that correct?
Absolutely.
Uh-huh. I see a lot of them at, what's the wing place over there?
Why do you know the wing place? We're talking about fitness,
no, well,
Stan.
This is where they hang out. This is where they hang out at.
All right.
I forgot the name of it. That's where they hang out at. I forgot the name of it. Oh, my goodness.
And they don't want you to tell their hangout spot. How about that?
You know what? I'm not going to say that.
Yeah, don't say,
right.
it. Don't say it. It's some place they hang out.
It's in DeKalb. I'm excuse me.
Yeah, it's in DeKalb County.
Yeah.
But I haven't hung out with them yet.
Right, okay.
You know, I guess I ain't on that level yet,
you
so to speak.
Okay,
you know.
Well, I see them out in DeKalb a lot to see what's going on.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Now, what's in the future for Tony Parker? What do you want to do? Where do you think you want to be?
Well, actually, what's in the future for me?
Mm-hmm.
God knows.
Yeah.
Honestly, I really can't foresee the future,
mm-hmm.
but I'm going to just continue to stay humble.
There you
and
go.
And just continue to stay prayed up and continue mm-hmm. to, you know, follow that passion.
Right.
You know, and just try to keep a positive energy.
That's the biggest thing,
It just lead me right on down the road. But however, I'm looking forward to being one of the leading roles and maybe
right.
a talk show, you know, you know.
Samantha, Stan, who? Yeah. Really?
Right.
Yeah.
So what would you have to say to a young person, especially a young male
sure.
that may be wanting to, do as you done, find that niche and they love acting or modeling. What would you tell them how to handle that?
I tell them all the time at the barbershop, little young brothers coming in,
mm-hmm.
they be trying to find employment and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So I asked them, you know, they see the pictures on my little booth and they say, Tony, man, you doing your thing. I said, wait, brother, this is, you know, and then that's when they start asking me, you know, about, you know, how can I get into
yeah,
it?
Yeah.
So I tell them, hey, you know, you might want to go, you know, sign up with 800 Casting,
mm-hmm.
you know, look on lovetoact.com.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they have like little stage plays.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes they be, you know, non-paid. But however, my first movie,
okay.
First Impression, actually that comes out 2013,
mm-hmm.
I think November actually.
Okay.
And I'm the bartender in the movie.
Uh-oh.
And it was a non-paid.
Mm-hmm.
But I went on faith. first movie ever.
Right.
So, you know, I'm in a little makeup room with Lamar Rucker, Lisa Anderson, just everybody in this movie. It's like 10 major stars.
So you really got paid, you didn't get the
yeah.
Right. Not tangible. The dollars, but you got the
tangible. Absolutely, yeah. But I went right. on faith knowing it was right. non-paid, but when I got there, I got a few extra $100. It's been a bartender.
Yeah, well, a lot of people are looking into that now because Atlanta is becoming a hub, almost they call it Hollywood of the South. Yeah, has it been absolutely. Easy for you to find casting directors or a casting call that you can just immediately go to if you wanted to, or are they few and far between unless you know somebody?
Facebook.
Okay. All right. Facebook. Tell us about that.
Get on Facebook
I'm
now.
I'm on Facebook, but okay.
Friend me. Yeah, yo, that's what we are, friends
yeah,
on Facebook.
Right. We are okay. friends on Facebook, right?
But however, Facebook uh-huh. is like, you know, media networking, sure. Network with folks, mm-hmm. people that's in the film industry, reach out to people, you know, and stuff will start coming. Now, right. I have a lot of stuff on my page that will draw the attention of other directors, right. producers, I'm taking pictures mm-hmm. with folks. They say, mm-hmm. hey, man, this guy is doing his thing, man, so, you know, they try to reach out to you. Right. But I would tell a young brother right. Or a young youth sister, right. female brother, hey, you know, search that web. Mm-hmm. Put our stuff on there, right. go to these networking mm-hmm. venues, go to these charity events, right. all this stuff. And some of the charity events may be free. You might have to donate $5 to get in the door, but you in the door with all these producers, directors.
Like that
right. Yeah. Porter
like
Sanford.
That. Right. You know,
Porter Sanford.
You know, I love that.
I was just there last Thursday, okay. connected okay. with a lot of people. Okay. I'm actually promoting the mm-hmm. Stage play that I'm in.
Oh, really?
Okay. Deceived, yeah.
Oh. Now, yes. where will it be held, that particular stage play? Will it be in DeKalb County?
Actually, no, unfortunately not. The producers, okay. I think they're going with a different venue this
okay.
year.
Mm-hmm.
But it's going to be out in Fayetteville,
okay.
Yes.
We'd like to have it in DeKalb if they want.
Yeah,
absolutely.
David Magnet does a great job out of the Porter Sanford Center
absolutely.
All the time. Yeah.
Absolutely, mm-hmm. yeah. And actually, the producer have another movie. Actually, the stage play would turn into a movie.
Oh, really?
So okay. that would be held at the Port of Sanford.
Hello, see.
Here
I
you
like
go.
That.
Call
absolutely.
They're not as though they were.
And will be. Now,
yes.
in your craft, you know, most of the time, you know, Samantha's a singer, so I know she practices maybe at home alone sometimes just to get it right.
And be practicing.
Do you actually practice your lines in the mirror, see how you look when you're talking for a certain portion of the film that you got to do something crazy, something special?
Absolutely. Absolutely, mm-hmm. I do that.
How do you do that?
You put him on this.
Well, actually, I learned.
Sometimes I got to speak real good today. So okay,
right.
and I'll be trying to make it look good. Now, if I say this word, is my lip gonna be over here? Or, you know.
Actually, I learned from the best.
Oh, hello.
I was Lawrence Fishburne's stand-in in the movie Ride Along, with
really?
Kevin Hart, Ice Cube.
It's coming on out.
Yeah,
okay.
For 90 days. For 90 days, I got there, sit there, watch him, you know, study his right. his craft.
Right.
So. But yes, I do be in the mirror.
Uh-huh.
I learned how to ad-lib from Lawrence Fishburne. Oh, I can't
really?
Wait to tell him that. But anyway, I learned it from him just by observing, watching and stuff. But yeah, you have to try to memorize some of your scripts.
Right.
You can't take on too many tasks at one time.
Right.
I try to do that. I had three different stage plays.
And you know which script it was had.
Right, absolutely. So
what
I actually,
song is that I'm singing?
Right. So the time, it doesn't allow you, your memory,
sure.
you know. So you want to actually give that producer, or director, you know, yes. the honest respect.
Right.
You know, if you can't work with him then, hey, you could just kindly say, hey, I'll work with you in the future. I have a lot of stuff going on.
I have some on my plate right now.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, that's good.
Absolutely. But you have to study your lines. You know, get your family members to actually, you know, try to quiz you on some of your lines
that's
and stuff
right.
like that.
You want any quizzes?
No, don't do that.
Okay.
I'm terrible with a teleprompter.
Okay.
What's that word? I mean, no, to make it work. What
time but I'm sorry.
Go ahead.
I would have to add, when you ask me about, you know, what can I actually offer someone
yeah.
to who's in it?
A young person especially.
Don't stop your energy.
There you go.
Don't never let nobody stop your energy. Nobody.
Mm-hmm.
I walked on a Tyler Perry set. Mm-hmm. I can't wait to tell him that. Where we at?
Right here. You just walked on.
I can't wait to tell him
and
that.
You didn't get arrested. They said, you was this guy. Get
well,
this guy.
Actually, I tried to submit to it. It was filmed in Avondale.
Oh, really?
In DeKalb County.
In DeKalb County. Yeah, right.
And I said, because I love DeKalb County
right,
so much.
Right.
I was at the barbershop. It was slow. I said, you know what? Let me go around there, man. They're going to have to tell me no.
Right.
You know, right after Thanksgiving, you know,
and
so yeah,
they got to arrest
but
me.
Actually, yeah. I had that hunger, and I said, you know what, I got that passion.
Going.
You know, they're gonna see me, so I learned a little bit about, you know, being in the industry, so I know who on the set, who was who. So I walked straight to wardrobe. You know, it was lucky for me, it was two females. I said, wardrobe, how do I look? She said, oh, you fine. Take off the jacket because it's a Waffle House scene. Turn it down a notch. I said, okay. So now I'm in a Single Moms Club, which is produced and directed by Tyler
just
Perry.
On the stage. Oh, wow. My goodness.
Okay. Yeah. Well, I just want to share
how
with the young viewers,
hey,
you know, don't give up, you know,
right.
But don't try to break the law in doing it.
Right. But just go
May
do what
I
you got to do.
Can I say something here as the attorney as for the show?
Yeah, absolutely. Right. You don't want to do that. You don't want to
Well,
do
awesome,
that.
Awesome,
awesome.
Well, I'm glad to see you again.
Likewise.
You have to give a shout out to Leo, because Leo probably watching tonight.
Leo watching tonight?
Yeah, Leo watching. He probably
Hey, Leo.
Me.
How you doing, man? Hey, we see you at the shop. We see you at the shop, brother.
We're great. Our guest has been Mr. Tony Parker, actor, model here in DeKalb and Atlanta, doing an awesome job. We hope he have great favor going forward and look for him to do bigger and better things. What
awesome.
Do you think?
Absolutely.
Well, great. We're going to take a quick break. We're going to be right back. You're watching the Stan Watson Show. And Samantha's doing an awesome job there. We'll fight afterwards, but she's doing a great job. Thank you so much. Stay right there. We'll be right back. I said, I know that guy. You've been listening to the awesome sounds of Rhythmic Rain. Samantha was supposed to sing with them, but she had a diva moment, so we're going to let someone else sing tonight, I guess. But you know how it works with Samantha. Well, we have a great guest, though, that's going to sing.
I know. And this lady is amazing, okay?
What's her name? Tell us her
you
name.
Might want to replace me if
Son,
you hear her.
Son, you
want
to come sing with me sometime?
I could never replace Miss Samantha.
No. You know what? That
she
might
knows
she's an awesome gift.
She, oh, I love it.
Okay, so we'll let you stay for one more week. Okay, great. And it's Miss Sonya McGuire.
Yes, sir, it is.
Great to see you.
Pleasure to be here. Thank you for having me.
Samantha's just been talking about how well you sing, the anointing. I mean, you've got a little diva in you, too. I mean, she said you're just awesome.
Well, to God be the glory.
Where are you from?
Atlanta, Georgia, actually.
Really?
Well, born and raised on the outskirts of Rockdale County, spent all of my days right there in Lithonia.
Okay.
Lithonia, excellent. Georgia, off Panola Road.
Off Panola Road. I understand your church is in DeKalb County as well. Where is that?
New Life International.
Give them a shout out there.
Oh, New Life International Family Church. Big shout out to Bishop Jerron C. Williams and First Lady Williams.
All right, well, good. I'm going to come over and see. I know where it is now. Samantha says, as always, it's in your district.
Oh, okay. You should know these things.
I should know these things.
Yes.
Talk about your songs and your style and how did you get started? I know people come on the show and we say, how did you get started? Well, I started singing in the choir or in the bathroom. You know, yeah. How did you get started?
Well, pretty much, I'm a preacher's kid. Okay. So my father, pastor, and kind of the unofficial family business was music.
Yeah.
So if you were going to be in the church, you had to do something.
Mm-hmm.
So I actually started out on the started out on the instruments and went from that to directing and singing, you know, mm-hmm. minister of music position in my father's church.
Oh,
and
really?
From there, it was kind of a wrap.
She got it going on.
It was a wrap.
She has it going on. Now, you're at your church, what do you do spiritually or in the ministry? What do you do?
Honestly, I'm just being fed because I travel a lot,
right.
Do a lot. A lot of times, you know, the artist, mm-hmm. we need to be, you know, ministered to because
well.
We minister
yes.
and we give so much out on the road, definitely.
Mm-hmm. Excellent. What's your inspiration or who are some of your inspiration? Types of person that help you to get where you are. So what do you like to listen to? I guess is my question.
Well, to start, I would have to say my family.
Okay.
My dad is a
musician.
Y'all
had a choir at home?
Pretty much. Pretty much. It was enough of us to have one.
Yeah, because
pretty much.
I'm a PK kid, and my dad used to sing when we didn't want to hear him sing.
Okay.
And then if the song was good, my mom might join in.
Okay.
But, you know, it was like those things that happen in the house. So, bing, here we go, make
it's
it work.
A family
right,
family.
Right,
okay,
right,
excellent.
Right. So, but definitely, you know, you have trailblazers
sure.
in gospel music. I've always been brought up on the Winans and,
mm-hmm.
you know, your Clark sisters mm-hmm. and, you know, just phenomenal gifts we have.
Sure.
Even, you know, coming over, I love Anita Baker. God bless her.
Okay.
I love her.
Yes, yes.
So I have different influences.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
But for the most, I would have to say those that are in the gospel industry have
sure.
really, you know, opened up a new vein, if you will,
right. mm-hmm.
for artists such as myself to be able to minister.
Mm-hmm. Now, there are a lot of labels in Atlanta. You was just talking to Tony Parker and talking about how the film industry has just sprang up in the state of Georgia. Here in Atlanta, the music industry is also comparable to the film industry because there are a lot of great artists in our area.
Definitely.
What do you think about the saturation of the different types of artists that we have in the Atlanta area?
I think it's awesome. They entitled Atlanta the New Black Hollywood.
The New Black Hollywood.
I would have to agree because there are so many awesome and phenomenal gifts right here in this city.
Sure. Yes.
And if they're not from here, now it's the melting pot.
It is.
So you have so many different from jazz to neo-soul to
mm-hmm.
contemporary,
yeah,
traditional,
yeah.
from one extreme to next. It's
that's
like
right.
any day of the week, you can go anywhere and hear a live band, live music.
See anybody.
Yeah,
anybody.
See anybody. Phenomenal, right.
Right.
You know,
she
so
been
it's
trying to get me down to the C room. I hadn't made it there yet.
Oh, you got to go.
I know. I got to go.
Live music.
That's oh, yeah, all the time.
See?
So we got to make it work. The song that you're going to do for us tonight, what's the title again?
It's entitled The Next Chapter.
And tell us a little bit about that.
Well, The Next Chapter is a song that God blessed me to write and produce. Literally, I was sitting and thinking, you know, a lot of times we find ourselves in situations in life
mm-hmm.
where we seem to just get stuck.
Okay.
We kind of focus on where we are, though we have a yearning for more. The song came to mind to me that God is still writing the next
sure.
chapter. You know, don't look at where you are right now, but know that there's much greater to come, that
right.
God is still writing. A lot of times people pick up a book and they read it and they think that's it. They close
right.
it, they put it down.
Mm-hmm.
But the thing about our book is that God continued to write. So while he's writing and turning those pages
mm-hmm.
in our book,
mm-hmm.
he he's the author and the finisher of our faith. So at the end of the day, you know, God is still writing the next chapter. And I just want to encourage those that may be going through, that may not be where they want to be, that God is still writing, that there is still greater for them. There's still more to come.
Well, I can't wait to hear it. We're going to take a quick break. So Matthew and I are going to take a quick break, and we'll come back and listen to this awesome songbird sing. What's the name one more time?
The next chapter. Yes, sir.
And we'll make sure that we have it right, George. Make sure we have it right, George. George is off stage, but we said, George, make sure we'll make it work. Stay right there. You watch the stand. Watch the show. We'll be right back.
Tonight on the show, and I am so excited to introduce our powerful singer. I'm telling you, you're going to be amazed by her. This is Sonya McGuire singing The Next Chapter.
If I had to tell you my life story, you would understand why he used it for his glory. I was in a messed up state. Looked good on the outside, crushed on the inside. Tried everything to fill this empty space. Impossibilities was all I could see. While serving God, the devil tried to blind me. When you thought you were at your end, life challenges seem to end.
God turned the pages.
To the hills, the devil is
liar.
This is not
your
end. No matter what you're going through, all a part of God's plan to build and make you. Don't try to comprehend, for it's all a part of God's plan.
Though people trying to throw up your past, God has I'm ready.
And welcome back to the Stan Watson Show again. I'm your host, Stan Watson, along with my lovely co-host, Miss Samantha Carwell. We've had a great time and great music tonight from Rhythmic Rain. We just had a great time with Tony Parker. Now, Tony told us he has to give a shout out to his barbershop or he's going to be in trouble. Uh-oh. And we might get a free barber. He said I might get a free cut out. It's okay. Dynamic Cuts Barbershop, Dynamic Cuts on Reed Ann Road. The number is 404-343-9054. So, all right, now, Tony, you owe me. I got a shout out for him, right?
We have
another great guest also is a singer, author, writer, Miss Deborah Hightower. Welcome to the Stan Watson
Thank
Show.
Thank you very much. Thank you for having me.
Not a problem. You have a book called The Secret to Winning Big.
Yes.
Tell us a little bit about that book. Samantha has it.
The book is really strategies for how your life and business can be expanded to be happier and more fulfilled. Mm-hmm. I co-wrote the book with other business professionals. Okay. And we share our secrets.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I mean, are these the corporate secrets or office politics? What kind of secrets do you share?
Ooh. Let's see.
Okay.
You can't tell everything.
Give us
a snippet in the book, man.
I'll just give you a little snippet.
Okay.
Really, how you can expand what you're already doing.
Really? Okay.
To be bigger and better.
Okay.
Dig out those extra gifts.
Okay.
You know, just because we're sitting behind a corporate desk doesn't mean that's all we do.
That's true.
And happiness and fulfillment, I think we sell ourselves short and we get in that grind of going to work, going home, going to work, going home, going to work, going home.
Right.
And
we
need to expand you. Exactly.
Okay.
We need.
Now you have a book and you also brought a CD. Tell us about what's the difference between the two here. What's going on? This is
a huge difference.
You know how my winning big, but this might be even bigger.
This is love, period.
This is love, period. Okay.
That's right. Does it get any bigger than love?
Mm-hmm.
And you know, I think this is applicable to anybody.
Sure.
If we're in corporate America, we certainly are not just that.
Right.
There are other gifts
that you have
that we
outside
have
of the office, the workplace.
Right. And we need to dig it out and polish them up. And do what makes our heart happy.
Really?
And music and writing makes my heart happy.
Okay.
I was going to say, you didn't say that you were singing on it, on this
the
CD. So this is not just a guide or a lecture or a collection of poems.
Mm-hmm.
This is Deborah singing, and she's written a lot of awesome songs on there, all about love,
period.
That's
right. That's right.
Now, how long have you been singing?
Oh, forever, since I was a teeny little kid, you know.
And
that goes back to the whole expansion idea. Mm-hmm. You know, we all have a lot of gifts that are deep down inside, and sometimes the timing is not quite right, to put them on display. And when the timing comes, you have to be ready.
Excellent.
You have to be ready for what you pray for.
That's right.
If you want your music to come out, you better be ready to
bring it.
For
the blessing.
Yeah.
Now, what are you singing for us tonight?
I am singing two songs.
Okay.
The radio hits right now are Hallelujah, Praise His Name, and Just For Who You Are.
Okay, well, great.
Yeah.
Well, we
got
to get a quick break. Can we do that? So we get back and try to get these two songs.
Okay, great.
We'll be listening to Miss Deborah Hightower. Stay right there. Samantha and I will be right back.
I'll just give you a little snippet.
Okay.
Really, how you can expand what you're already doing.
Really, okay.
To be bigger.
Mm-hmm.